examples. Sketch the following indicating or intercept. One, P of X is equal to X3 minus 2X squared minus 1. Dealing with such questions, step one of polynomials step one is to factorize the polynomial. But to factorize, we need to find a fact by trial method. Using the factors of the constant and of the coefficient of the highest degree. So that we get a function P and try one, which is a factor of one and negative one. We will get 1 plus 2 minus 1. This is giving us 2, which is not 0. We try negative 1. We get negative 1 power 3 plus 2 negative 1 squared minus 1, giving us negative 1 plus 2 minus 1, which is 0. When I tick there, I'm saying that x is equal to 1 is a fact. So I get this value 1. In synthetic, you get the coefficients of the polynomial. For x3, we get 1. For x squared, we get 2. For x, we get 0. And we get negative 1. And then we drop the first number. That first number comes down here, and then multiply this one by this one. The number you get, you put here, and add the number you get here. You multiply this by this number and take there, do the addition. The number you get here, you multiply this by this one. The number you get, you take there, and then add. And you get a 0 here if it is a fact. So that we have a 1, 1 times 1, we get a 1. We add 2 plus 1, we get a 3. And
it's negative 1.
All right, so I was confused. Hey, since when has such a thing happened in this life? So we drop a 1. So we have negative 1 here, add, get a 1. Negative 1, add, get a negative 1. Multiply 1, we add, we get a 0. When the remainder is zero, we are now saying we can write px as a product of x minus one, this one taken the other side, multiplied by this function that comes out here. The degree of this function will be less by one to the original function. So we'll have x squared plus x minus one. You use these as the coefficients of the polynomial. Then step two.
They had to be positive. X plus one.
So this is minus one. So it will be x plus one. Yeah. So step two, you equate the factorized polynomial to zero in order to find the x-intercepts. So we have px is equal to zero, implying that x plus one, x squared plus x minus one is equal to zero, giving us x is equal to negative one, x squared plus x minus one is equal to zero. For this one, we use the formula x is equal to negative b plus or minus the root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a, so that we get negative 1 plus or minus 1 minus 4, 1 by neg 1, everything over 2 by 1. So we get negative 1 plus or minus root of 5 over 2, implying that x is equal to negative 1 plus root 5 over 2, or x is equal to minus 1 minus root 5 over 2. Okay, now sketch. But before we sketch, step 3, we find the y-intercept. By solving
so what is
t of zero.
Sir.
Hello.
In terms of factorization, if you want, you can use the different of two squares.
You only use the difference of two squares if it exists. But this case is different. It's not difference of two squares. So if you want, you can use the factors if they are there. But for this case, we don't have.
All right.
So find the y-intercept by solving p of zero. So what is p of zero? P of zero is just a constant because we have 0 power 3 plus 2, 0 minus 1. So we just get minus 1, implying that the point is 0 comma negative 1. Then you sketch step 4. Sketch p of x. To sketch, we have intercepts, negative one minus root 5 over 2, negative 1 plus root 5 over 2. How do you know it will be this root 5 thing here when you combine it to be less than negative 1? You approximate. Root 5 is bigger than root 4. But root 4 is 2. So this number is 2 point something. So negative 1 minus 2 point something over 2 this will be negative 3 point something over 2, which is negative 1 point something. Meaning it is less than negative 1. And then root 5 minus 1 over 2. Of course, this is 2 point something minus 1 over 2. You get 1 point something over 2, which is positive. That's how we know whether to be positive or negative. Then the y-intercept is what gives us the orientation of this graph. The y-intercept is 0, negative 1. This means that our graph cannot come this way because we will fail to come here. It must cross all these four intercepts. The only way that is possible is when maybe you start from here, come like that, like this. So you go like that, come here, come like that. Or you go like that, come here, go like that. But for where I should turn from between this and that region, compare this distance here. Negative 1 is bigger. This distance is bigger than that one there, meaning that the graph is going to go down and go up like that. So our sketch will be going this way without knowing the turning point, come down. Without knowing the turning point, turn. This is f of x. And this is p of x, I mean. So have you seen that when they say sketch, you've actually been asked to factorize. You've actually been asked to solve px, because this, when they say solve for x, we find these values of x. We find this value, we find this value, we find where the other value, we found this value. When they say solve for x. So if you ask to solve the polynomial, they're asking you to solve the x-intercepts, if you were to sketch. If they say factorize, they want you to get here. And if this one is factorizable, factorize it fails. So when they say sketch, indicating all the intercepts, they have said factorize, they have said solve, and then that's when you have a normal sketch. The only thing that we're waiting for now is we're waiting for calculus to come and tell us how to get these turning points, that one and this one. That's all. Question?
Sir, how can you know that your graph must start from the top or down?
Following the y-intercept. Imagine if we didn't know what to do and started from this side. How can you maneuver through your points to make sure that you cross all of them? I've been seeing that it will be very difficult because it will require you to do, look at this. Go there, I don't know where you turn from. If you manage to turn. You're trying to look for how to cross all the intercept. So it becomes that. Because already we don't know what this is.
Yeah.
So even if you would try, it will remind you that you are wrong. So it's just to try. Okay, if you don't know what to do, then just try to sketch the other direction.
All right, so
okay. So,
sir, how did you find the zero? That's zero, comma negative one. How did you find the zero?
The since x is zero throughout the y axis, whenever I'm looking for the y intercept, I just take zero where there is x. I'll get the y intercept.
So it's a must to put zero in the x.
It's axis. A must. That one is a must.
All right, thank you, sir.
The same way it is a must to equate this to zero to get the x intercept. Because this px is representing y, but y is zero on the x-axis. That's why we equate the whole function to zero whenever we're looking for the x-intercept. It's a must to all functions in this world. Okay. Let me now look for the tutorial sheets and get examples of polynomials. Where do you find such? Tutorial sheet four, I think. Tutorial sheet four, yes. Another example will come from tutorial sheet four. This was example at one. Example two. Find the zeros of each of the following polynomial functions, hence sketch its graph indicating the x and y intercepts. So what we'll do is to stop. Oh, let me check if you have written very well. Our question is sketch then one, two, okay. So we're going to do two. P of x is equal to negative x3 plus x squared plus 5x minus 2. Let's see. First step, we said you factorize, so look for the factors, get the coefficients of, get the factors of the constant or the coefficient of the highest degree. So the factors of negative two or negative one. So start. Let's start with one. It will give us negative one plus 5 minus 2. This is not zero. Negative one. It will give us plus one here. Plus 1 minus 5 minus 2. This is not zero. Let's go to two. Negative 8 plus 4 plus 10 minus 2. Is this zero? This is not zero. It's like negative 2 is our last hope. To give us 8 here, to give us 4 here, minus 10 minus 2 is equal to 0, finite. So we get negative 2, bring in negative 1, synthetic now, 1, 5, negative 2. Drop the negative 1, multiply, we get 2, add, get 3, multiply, negative 6, add negative 1, multiply positive 2, add 0. So px can now be written as x plus 2. So whenever this is negative, when you say x, you will say plus. If it was positive, we would have said x minus. So, and then negative x squared plus 3x minus 1. And then equate this to zero. so that we can look for the x-intercepts. So we have x plus 2, negative x squared plus 3x minus 1 is equal to 0, giving us x is negative 2. And then negative x squared plus 3x minus 1 is equal to 0. This one looks like only the formula can help. So x negative 3 plus or minus the square root of 3 squared, which is 9, minus 4ac over 2 minus 1. This is negative 3 plus or minus the root of 5 over negative 2. What a coincidence, eh?
So, excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Negative 2 cube is what? Is it 8 or negative 8?
Negative 2 cube is negative 8. Then there will be a negative outside to make it positive.
Oh, okay, thank you. Thank you, sir. Uh-huh.
So x is equal to negative 3 plus root 5 over negative 2. Or x is negative 3 minus root 5 over negative 2. Then we can sketch now, because all we need is the y-intercept, which is p0 negative 2. So we get 0 comma negative 2. Then we can have our sketch.
Sir, is it okay if we say, since there's negative 3 and down there's also negative 2, is it okay if we just say positive 3 and positive 2? Like, can the negatives cancel each other there?
They must cancel. If we are to cancel, it must be 3 plus root 5 over 2.
Oh, thank you.
And the other one should be 3 minus root 5 over 2.
Oh. Okay.
Mm-hmm. If we have a simplified one. So this will help us to know the intercept. So we have x negative 2. So I put negative 2 here. The other one is 3. 3 minus root 5. That is a positive number. So it is here. 3 minus root 5. Remember I said root 5 is 2 point something over 2. And then the other guy is also negative. That means also positive, 3 plus root 5 over 2. Then where the y-intercept is down here, negative 2. So if you look at the gaps, this gap here is bigger than this one there. So you work with a bigger gap in terms of the turning point. So if we are confused, but there's a negative one that lies in between here. Hello?
Sir, excuse me. On the three there, doesn't it have a negative in front of it? Like three, negative three minus root five, negative three plus.
What has happened is this. It was this over negative two, is it? In fact, that a negative from top, you get 3 plus that over negative 2. Then negative, negative.
Oh, all right, sir.
Sir, the y-intercept, do we get it from the original equation or the factorized equations?
From the original equation.
Thank you.
Uh-huh. What about the factorized one? Can it still, even the factorized one, it can still come out? As long as you take 0 here, 0 there.
Yeah, even the factorized one,
so. To give us negative 2. But the original one is nicer because there's no solving. Just get the constant. So if you look at P of negative one, you will notice that we're actually getting what? Negative 7 plus 2, which is negative 5, lower than negative 2. So it just makes sense to know that I'm dealing with so many things are coming back. But I want to remove this. Okay. Then we sketch. So again, you can see that if you tried going this direction, you don't know where to turn from, so that you come there and you just be turning anyhow, because you leave out this point and turn from where you don't know, meaning that you cannot use that orientation. So the required orientation is this one. This is the required orientation. So if the question was saying solve P of X is equal to zero, you would have ended here without sketching and without this. But now it's not saying so, it's saying sketch. So we proceed to the sketch. Okay, so we can log out and come back to continue. Now, these videos, I post them as early as the class ends. The challenge is that most of you are not subscribed to the channel, so it takes you time to know that it has been posted. Not until I remember that I haven't brought it in the group. That's when you get to know that the video is there. Subscribing is just for free. It's not charging yet. We'll charge you the day you become more interested. Okay, let's come back. Let's log out and come back. Just remember to save this. Okay.